Good morning to all. Today we are going to study Animal Communication Engineer subject. In that subject, our sixth chapter we have started already. Along with that sixth chapter, so many points we are studied. That is the sources of noise, how that noise is occurred, how that noise is removed. Along with that, noise parameters having some different parameters. That is the signal to noise ratio, noise figure, noise temperature, noise factor. These are the parameters we are going to study one by one today. Along with this, we have studied all these parameters related to that noise chapter. Along with this, only two parameters are remaining. That is a noise factor and noise figure and noise temperature. That two points today we are going to study in our this lecture. Okay. So first of all, I am going to start what is the noise figure. Then what is the definition or what is the meaning of that noise figure? That noise figure, sometimes the noise factor is expressed in decibels. When the noise factor is expressed in a decibel, then that is called as a noise figure. Then what is the formula for the noise factor? The noise factor is expressed in terms of F. For that purpose, here noise figure is mentioned, that is F dB is equal to 10 log to the base 10 F. Substituting these expression for the noise factor, we get. What is the noise figure? Noise figure is nothing but 10 log to the base 10 noise factor. What is the noise factor formula? That is the signal to noise ratio at the input side divided by signal to noise ratio at the output side. We know very well. In log terminology, whenever the two terminologies are present in terms of ratio, then we are going to take subtraction of all these two quantities. Like this, we are going to differentiating this formula. That is, FdB is equal to 10 log to the base 10 signal to noise ratio at the input side minus 10 log to the base 10 signal to noise ratio at the output side. For that purpose, that is, the noise figure dB is equal to S by N at input dB minus S by N at output dB. The ideal value of noise figure is 0 dB. We know very well. What is the ideal relation for that signal to noise ratio at the input side and signal to noise ratio at the output side? Whenever the signal to noise ratio at the input side and output side come into picture, that is equal, then that is considered as the ideal value for that signal to noise ratio. For that purpose, the ideal value of that noise figure is 0 dB. Then by taking one example, we are going to considering or we are going to calculating how that noise figure, noise factor, all these quantities we are going to calculate mathematically, just we are going to study here. For that purpose, I have given here one mathematical statement related to that. Just go through that statement. There is a signal power and noise power measured at the input of an amplifier are 150 microwatt and 1.5 microwatt respectively. If the signal power at the output, that is a 1.5 watt, and noise power is a 40 milliwatt, calculate the amplifier noise factor and noise figure. Here, whatever the data given, first of all, we are going to find out, that is a PSI, that means signal input power is a 150 microwatt. Signal noise input power, it is a 1.5 microwatt. Signal output power is a 1.5 watt. And signal noise output power, it is a 40 microwatt. According to this, by using these values, we are going to calculate that noise factor and noise figure. But here, what they given, they are given in terms of signal input power and output power, as well as along with noise input power and noise output power. For that purpose, we are going to considering that noise factor formula, which is involving signal input power, noise input power, signal output power, and noise output power. Like this, here by using these equations, just to put out these equations value by given data, and we get what is the noise factor value, that is a 2.666. Then noise figure. Noise figure is nothing but 10 log to the base 10 noise factor value. What is that noise factor value came into picture here? That is a 2.6666. For that purpose, that 6 is a above 5 digit number. For that purpose, we are going to remove third factor and by adding our previous factor by 1. So that purpose, what is the output get here? That is a 10 log to the base 10 2.667. It is converted into in terms of dB, that is by using 10 log to the base 10, that is a 4.26 dB. This is the output value related to noise figure and noise factor. Along with this, I have taken another example related to this, that is a just go through that statement, that is a signal to noise ratio at the input of an amplifier is a 40 dB. If the noise figure of an amplifier is a 20 dB, calculate the signal to noise ratio in a dB at the amplifier output. This is all over related to that input statement and output statement. Then noise figure. Noise figure is expressed in a dB is equal to signal to noise ratio at a input in dB minus signal to noise ratio output in a dB. Then we are going to converting that signal to noise ratio input output like this by taking that signal noise figure here, signal to noise ratio at output dB, that is nothing but 40 minus 20 is equal to 20 dB. For the consideration amplifier, that is a noise resistance is a 0, then noise factor is a 1, then the noise figure would be also in a 0 dB. This is a 0 dB related to standardization output related to noise factor. This is all the related to noise figure, but today only one part is related, remaining related to that noise chapter, that is a noise temperature. Here I have given that noise temperature related all these things. Then what is the meaning of that noise temperature? Noise factor or a noise figure cannot be always used for the measuring of a noise. For that purpose, another way to represent the noise is a means equivalent, that is a noise temperature. The equivalent noise temperature is used in dealing with a very high frequency and microwave, low noise antennas, receivers and devices. There we are going to use, that is a noise temperature. Then what is the definition of that noise temperature? The definition of noise temperature here I have given, that is a equivalent noise temperature of a system is defined as a temperature at which the noisy resistor has to be mentioned so that by conducting connecting this resistor to be input of a noiseless version of the system, it will be produces the same amount of a noise power at the system output as that produces by the actual system. Then equivalent noise temperature is T equivalent at a amplifier input. The equation related to that noise temperature here I have given, that is a noise at the input of an amplifier input is given by the equation as a PNDA is equal to noise F for noise factor minus 1 KT0B. K is nothing but Boltzmann constant, T0 is a room temperature, B is a nothing but bandwidth. We know very well what is the relation and what is the equations related to all these things. Then this is the noise contributed by the amplifier. This noise power can be alternatively represented by some facilities temperature T equivalent, such that noise power at the amplifier side is given by KT equivalent into B. That is KT equivalent B is equal to F minus 1 KT0B. Then BB gets cancelled from each side. Thus the equivalent noise temperature of the amplifier is given by T equivalent is equal to F minus 1 T0, or F, that is a noise factor, is equal to 1 plus T equivalent divided by T0. This shows that the T equivalent is just an alternative measurement for the F. For example, an amplifier has a noise figure of a 3 dB. Calculate its equivalent noise temperature. Then here I am going to calculate what is the equivalent noise temperature related to this. That is, calculate the noise figure. F dB is equal to 10 log to the base 10 F ratio. That is, a noise factor F is equal to anti log F dB divided by 10. Anti log of F dB divided by 10, that is a 0.3 value. What is that value? Noise factor is equal to 1.910. That is, the noise factor is always represented in the whole terminology. For that purpose, here approximately 1.99 noise factor is considered as a 2. Then next formula is to calculate the T equivalent, that means equivalent temperature. That equivalent temperature is calculated by the formula T equivalent is equal to noise factor minus 1 divided by T0, that is a room temperature. What are the values related to F and T0? We know very well, that is a F we have calculated just now, that is a 2 minus 1 into, we know very well, that is a room temperature, that is a 27 degree centigrade room temperature, and we have to convert that room temperature into degree Kelvin by adding 273. While we are going to add that 273 along with 27 degree room temperature, then the temperature came into picture, that is a degree Kelvin, that is a 300. For that purpose, the temperature here considered as a 300. Then by 2 minus 1 is, what is the value came into picture? 1. 1 multiplied by 300 is equal to 300 degree Kelvin. That is the equivalent temperature related to all these terminologies or all these examples. Okay, this is all the terminologies and all the things related to noise chapter, as well as our, that is the input terminology, output terminology. Once the noise is occurred in any kind of a communication system, how we are going to overcome along with this noise, we have studied all these things. This study will help you to study or motivate how to reduce the noise, or how to minimize the noise which is introduced at the transmitter side as well as receiver side while communicating with one end to another end, that is from transmitter to receiver. So by using these terminologies or by using these tricks, we are going to, as an engineer, our task is to reduce or to minimize the noise occurred in any kind of a system. And with the help of this, I am sure that you will reduce the noise in future while you are transmitting signal from transmitter to receiver. Okay, along with this, our ninth chapter is finished. Thank you.